How you doing? This is Terrion Wilson, aka your boy, Brotha T, here with another one. Today we're going to talk about something special, okay? So you always hear me talk about consumers versus investors. If you haven't heard me talk about these things, go find some of those videos. I have a video specifically on consumers versus investors, because it's going to tie in, even though I'm going to touch on consumers and investors in this video. But there's a third way, okay, other than consuming and investing. Before I get into that though, I need you to subscribe, because if you like and subscribe, then I can show you a different way to look at life, prosperity, and generational wealth. All right, so let's get into it. Let's tackle consumer versus investor first, and then we'll get to the third way you can handle your money, okay? So what's a consumer, right? So a consumer just is a person that just buys things, right? So let's say you pay all your bills and then you have a little bit of money left over. Some people call that disposable income. And what a consumer does, or person that's in the consumer mindset, they take that disposable income and they usually buy things with it, right? They try to buy little items, luxury items, sometimes things that they don't even need, or things that they're going to throw away pretty soon, stuff that they just don't need. That's what consumers do. Now, we all are consumers on some level. We have to consume in order to survive at a certain level. But I'm talking about people with the consumer mindset, meaning every time they have any kind of extra money, extra cash, or disposable income, they're always spending it on things that they don't really benefit from. So what's an investor? An investor is a person that seeds something in order to get a return, right? Almost like planting something in the ground, like a plant, you know, or a flower, right? You put something in there, you're expecting a return. And usually it's done by money. Okay, that's not the only way you can invest, but that's the, you know, that's the probably the most common way, right? You invest money, and once you invest money, you expect to get a return at a certain point, right? Those are consumers, those are investors. When you do consumer versus investor, of course, that's why you're watching T's Money Tree. You want to be an investor. You want to be in the investor mindset versus the consumer. But there's a third way that you can handle your money, right? And what's that third way? By being a producer. A producer. Okay, so what's a producer versus the other two, right? So a producer is somebody that builds, okay? They build structures, they build systems, they build communities, they build businesses, right? Let's put it in these terms, right? So I can just be an investor in that I can find a good company, invest money in it, and I can wait on my return, right? Like the stock market. Or I can be the producer. Now, the producer is the person who owns the company that you're trying to invest in. That would be the producer, okay? Now, being that third person, the producer, that gives you ultimate power in this financial game. In capitalism, the producer is the one on top of that pyramid, okay? So you ask me, like, investor, producer, it seems kind of similar. It is, but there's a little bit of a distinction sometimes, okay? Now, a producer, okay, by definition, is an investor, okay? But every investor isn't necessarily a producer. That's the difference, okay? So if you're a producer, then you're more than likely an investor already, all right? But you can be an investor and not be a producer, okay? I hope that made sense. So if you have to choose one, you want to be one of the other two, investor, producer, or both, right? A combination of both. Okay, so this has been your man, Brother T. I just wanted to lay a quick video on you just so you can be aware of what a producer is. Before I go, I just want to give you a chance to join our Investaroot 4-module course. If you are interested in the 4-module course, it's an online course. You can do it from the privacy of your own home. You can go at your own pace. It's an online course. course. If you are interested, all you have to do is go to www.lifetreecourse.com. If you want 20% off, we have a coupon. Just put the word money tree deal in the coupon section and you will get 20% off. Who doesn't want money off of something that's already low priced? Right? And if you want to get like a little primer, a little starter, you can also go to tmoneytree.com and take one of our free introductory courses right before you take the four-module course. Now, make me a promise. If you go take the free introductory course, make me a promise that you'll consider taking the four-module course. Now, this has been your man, Brother T. I am out of here, family. Peace.